Hey guys, I'm just outside of Waco, Texas today at this incredible two-story shipping container home. The bottom floor is a 40-foot container, up top is a 20-foot container, and it has two bedrooms and two baths. It's also just 15 minutes away from Magnolia Market, which is a great area to explore, but more on that later. For now, let's hop into a tour of this container home out here in Waco. It's time to check out this incredible two-story shipping container home in Waco, Texas. This is definitely one of my new favorite container homes. I just love how they uniquely stacked these two containers on top of each other, in addition to the red paint job, which I don't see too often. One of the coolest exterior features by far is the fact that you can actually open up these two black doors. They are way heavier than they look because of these gigantic thick glass panels. I think this is such a smart way though to open up the space in this container, considering it's not terribly large. It just made it feel twice as big as it actually is, and this is a great spot to start your morning. Next up, the container home looks absolutely gorgeous at night. When you turn on all of the interior, exterior, and string lights on, you'll also definitely notice that second floor outdoor deck. More on that shortly. Lighting is such an important part of an Airbnb, in my opinion, and these hosts just nailed it. Next up, to finish off the exterior, I'll briefly talk about the surrounding area. You can see the same host other container home Airbnbs down below. And then just a short drive away in Waco is the famous Magnolia Market. These owners here basically took these two silos and designed an entire marketplace around them. There's a bunch of great food and dining options, and also shopping as well if you're into home decor and interior design. This was all started by the famous HGTV couple, Chip and Joanne Gaines, from the show Fixer Upper. Now it's time to open up this door and head on inside to check out the interior. This is the view you'll see as soon as you enter, looking into the kitchen and living room area at the end. If we switch sides, this is now looking out towards the hallway and the first floor bedroom. Straight ahead is the dining table, which has three chairs already equipped with some glasses, bowls, and plates out. I'm also always a fan of a personal touch, so they had a nice welcome sign waiting for me. Moving along, we'll now walk deeper into the container and enter into the kitchen. Starting over here on the right-hand side, we have a double sink, which takes up the majority of this countertop space in addition to your Keurig maker. On the opposite end, this kitchen is very well equipped, so it comes with a toaster oven and a microwave. I was a huge fan of these cute storage bins, which contains everything from your tea bags to coffee and sugar. There's also a brochure for the company Cargo Home, which is the ones who built this place. More info linked down below. Continuing on in the kitchen, if we inch up further, there are two shelves with additional glasses and mugs. Keep in mind there are two bedrooms in this container, so you can fit a bunch of people who may all want their coffee. And last but not least, down here you do have a fridge. Next, we'll now venture into the living room space. You have some comfy furniture like the chair and your sofa on the left. Also, above this sofa hanging on the wall, you have this lovely piece of art. Now, directly across the way, we have this piece, which may just look like a normal shelf, but it's actually quite unique. If you hit a few buttons, out pops your TV. I mean, how cool is this? It's also a great way to save space when you're pretty restricted inside of the container. And yes, it is a smart TV, so you can stream all of your favorite shows during your stay. After the living room, we're now gonna walk to the opposite end of the bottom floor, the 40-foot container, and we'll enter into the bathroom here. You have this beautiful white subway tile within the shower. Then on the opposite end, you have some more shelves, which is again, great use of the space, I think. Then a bunch of free bathroom amenities waiting for you on top of the toilet. If we now step back into the hallway and open up that door, we're gonna walk to the far end of this bottom container and enter into the first of two bedrooms. We have a queen size mattress inside of this room. Above the bed, you also have your air conditioning unit and some decorative artwork, not to mention two nightstands on either side, complete with some lamps and plants, just to add a nice little touch to this space. Finally, if we lay in bed now, along the far wall, you have a mirror attached to the sliding door. On the right side, you have this sort of cubby space with some extra blankets, an ironing board, and some hangers. That's it for the first floor and the bottom 40-foot container. So we're now gonna walk up the spiral staircase to check out the outdoor deck and the 20-foot container, which includes the master bedroom. The outdoor deck has two Adirondack chairs and this little coffee table. And if we walk this way, you have a cool view looking to the other containers on this lot. The containers come in all different shapes and sizes. I just love how they turn this space into an outdoor deck versus just using two 40-foot containers. We'll now walk down this way and open up these double doors to check out the final interior space. And now we're into the beautiful master bedroom, which is definitely more spacious than the downstairs bedroom. We have another queen size mattress inside of this bedroom, complete with an extra blanket and plenty of pillows. Also, the same decorative artwork that we saw downstairs is also here, just above the bed on a little shelf space. But the biggest difference between the bedrooms is definitely this little sitting area in the corner where you have this nice chair and some tables. Now, along the opposite wall, you may just think this is another piece of art, but these hosts are really good at hiding TVs. You have another smart TV inside here, so you don't even have to leave your bed to watch your favorite show. We can look back this way towards the doors, and you have a nice view towards the outdoor deck, and yes, some curtains you can pull across for privacy. Now we'll walk to the other end of the 20-foot container, and behind the wall, behind the bed, we have some more storage space back here, a couple shelves and some hangers, so if you want to hang up your clothes or store your luggage, this is where you're gonna do it. Finally, we'll slide this last door aside and come into the second bathroom inside of this container home. It's quite similar to the downstairs one, so I won't spend too much time here, but you notice, again, there's plenty of storage space and shelves throughout this. There's just washcloths and bath towels everywhere that you look, in addition to those free bathroom amenities waiting for you on top of the toilet. You also have another beautiful shower here, complete with subway tile and some cool octagon-shaped tiles there in the middle. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to give the video a thumbs up. You can also check out my container home playlist linked out down below. And I will see you next week for a brand new Airbnb tour.